Today's comic is going to be especially delicious. This is Quincy and the Dames. So I found this on Comic Fury, and it should go without saying that there's going to be spoilers, you know, when I'm reviewing something, but this is also going to be the most adult story that I have covered so far. It's going to have, you know, some crazy shit in it. And at first, it kind of seemed off-putting to me. I was like, what kind of juvenile fantasy is this going to be? It's like some kid porking hot sluts. But, you know, I couldn't have been more wrong. And this was the most creative story, you know, I'd ever seen. And this guy is a damn genius. Look at how much just creative intelligence there is crammed into this. All these fucking ideas. And I can tell that in this guy's mind, man, there's so much just genius intelligence going on. And these designs here, like that this robot, he looks like so goofy, like a toy, but that should be the goal, because eventually you do want to have franchise and toys and merchandise and video games. And I do think that eventually this thing will blow up. And they do say that, you know, every overnight success story takes 10 years. I mean, look at this detail, the coiled little turds on the floor. I love it. And I do think if this comic can just get some more exposure and get to the people who will appreciate it, that this will become something really big. So look at these character designs here. I mean, if you don't think that this is just absolute genius, then you're just wrong. So this story to me is kind of like Blade Runner meets One Piece, or like Judge Dredd meets Adventure Time. It kind of reminds me of Dorohedoro too. It also reminds me a lot of the Cosmic Warrior stuff that I make. And I mean, there is some bad themes, I guess, like gangsterism and cannibalism, but he's just trying to show us this world is fucked up.